Tablas Creek, so you do things subtly here.
Yes, we like...
In small batches?
Yeah, we like small barrels. Very, very small barrels.
How many normal-sized barrels are in each one of these?
20.
20.
So they're 1,200 gallons. Okay. And so each one of these has 500 cases of wine in it. And the idea is that the larger the barrel, the less contact there is between wine and barrel, and the more subtle the impact of the oak.
Ah, that's interesting. But don't a lot of winemakers look for impact of the oak?
Yes, a lot of winemakers do, but we're not a lot of winemakers. And a lot of that's defined by what kind of wines we make. I mean, we do Rhone varieties, and in general, I mean, with the exception of Syrah and Roussan, that both can handle some oak, I mean, you wouldn't want oak on Grenache. You wouldn't want oak on Viognier. It sure. Just kind of weighs them down.
So what's in these barrels? What do we got?
This is the 2009 Esprit de Beaucastel. So that's our flagship red. It got blended last summer, and it's going to spend another 8 months or so in here, and it'll be bottled next summer. I mean, Tablas Creek is a partnership between my family and the family of winemakers from the Rhone Valley. And so, I mean, they've been doing this for six generations, and between my dad and my grandfather and his uncle, I mean, we've been selling wines from other places for a long time, but this is our first time actually in the cellar. We get a ton of people in Arizona, from Arizona here. It's probably number two after California in terms of the actual physical walk-in traffic. A lot of people who live in Phoenix area have second houses in Southern California, and if they're in Southern California, they're in Palm Desert, they're outside of LA, they're in Santa Barbara. I mean, it's pretty accessible to get here. I think Grenache is going to be increasingly popular. It's got lots of fruit, it's got great acidity, it's friendly with food, it's something that you can grow successfully in a lot of different parts of California. So I think it's something which is going to be exciting. Any trends in American wine start in California, and then they move outward from there. If you plant based on what you think is going to be popular, you're going to miss the boat. If you plant based on what you think is going to be great where you are, your audience will find you. And what we find is that such a huge vector for this is the people who physically come to tasting rooms, or visit the wineries. You know, we have 25,000 people come through this tiny little tasting room this year. And that the ability to tell your story to that number of people and have them go back home and retell the story to their friends, or bring a bottle of wine that they bought here and share it with other people who they know, and then retell the story. And it's such an incredibly powerful marketing opportunity.
Sure.
The business side of it doesn't keep me up anymore. It used to. The things that keep me up are the worries of a farmer. I mean, whether it's, are we going to get frosted this night in April after everything is sprouted, or are we going to get rain during harvest, or sort of the things that are outside of your control, the things that it does absolutely no good to worry about, I still worry about. If you don't get the conditions that you need to ripen your grapes, you don't have a lot of options. Right now, I would suggest that people find the 2006 Esprit de Beaucastel. So the Esprit de Beaucastel is our flagship wine. We do a white and a red. This is the red, and we go through periodically and taste every vintage we've ever made of certain wines. And the last three or four times we've done this, out of all the different vintages of Esprit de Beaucastel, the 2006 is singing. And just to give you a little bit of credibility in my choice, after doing this, this is the wine that we're serving at the Tablas Creek holiday party later this week. So, I mean, we're doing a bunch of wines from other places and other producers, and pick one Tablas Creek wine, this is it. Cette tombe en sandwich entre le ciel.